Brian, what's on your radar?
So the Senate parliamentarian has one last major opinion to issue when it comes to the reconciliation bill, and that's the question of immigration reform. Now, let's be clear. The parliamentarian, Elizabeth McDonough, is only a staffer and is only supposed to issue an advisory opinion. But senators treat it like the word of God, which then gives it a weight it doesn't deserve. Now, on the question of immigration, it deserves basically no weight at all. Now, we don't know a lot about this mythical parliamentarian creature who controls all of our destinies, but here she is talking about her early career, speaking at the 2018 commencement of her alma mater, Vermont Law School.
My first week of work as a trial attorney at the Department of Justice, I was given the choice of heading straight into court or shadowing my colleagues for a day or two. I chose to shadow. I was able to go over case files with my experienced colleagues and see how they handled evidence, observe how different judges ran their courtrooms, and get a feel for the flow of a day's work in that new environment. That was an incredibly helpful experience, and it gave me a boost of confidence on day four when I actually went to court. I must have seemed pretty confident because opposing counsel didn't seem to know it was my first day, and he tried to intimidate me by telling me he had never lost a case. Well, it was my first day, so I'd never lost a case either. And he lost that one to me.
Okay, so what was the result of that victory she's so proud of? We don't know exactly what case she's talking about, but we do know what she was doing in general. She was deporting people. In that clip, she says she was a Justice Department attorney, which is true, but not the whole truth. She was a trial attorney for the agency Immigration and Naturalization Services, known as INS, just before taking her job in the parliamentarian's office. Her prior work helping deport immigrants has gone largely unnoticed, but the Refugee and Immigrant Center's Texas chapter called McDonough out for it, saying that her role is supposed to be one of an unbiased referee. The parliamentarian is supposed to be the nonpartisan referee of the Senate's rules, but McDonough is not an impartial voice on the issue of immigration. Before becoming the Senate parliamentarian, McDonough worked as a trial attorney handling immigration cases for the U.S. Department of Justice. As someone who has worked to deport people, she cannot be trusted to rule objectively on immigration issues. The question before her now is whether a new proposed approach to immigration reform Democrats have worked on can be included in their budget reconciliation package under the Byrd rule. The details are beside the point. There are parliamentary experts who can make arguments about the provision's compliance on both sides. So that means it's a judgment call. That makes the background and politics of the person making the judgment call of central importance. If the parliamentarian offers an opinion that the provision is kosher, then it can go into the bill. If she says no, then it sets off a big fight because the president of the Senate, Kamala Harris, is fully within her rights to ignore McDonough's advice and include it anyway. People angry at that decision would need 60 votes to take it out, but they could also threaten to simply take the entire bill down. But would Joe Manchin do that? Who knows? Manchin might take the whole thing down anyway. The news that McDonough served as an INS prosecutor gives Harris that much more reason to ignore her opinion. From an immigrant perspective, it must be wild to learn that the fate of the legislation is in the hands of somebody who used to help with deportations. But from a biased perspective, there's genuine reason to believe that her experience working in the field of immigration has actually distorted her sense of perspective on the question. After she nixed the minimum wage from reconciliation, she issued a one-line advisory opinion. No explanation, no analysis, nothing but a no. That was absurd, she was told by Democratic leaders. She's a staffer. If she's asked for an opinion, they don't want just a yes or no. They want a real analysis. The White House Office of Legal Counsel, for instance, if they're asked to weigh in on a legal question, they prepare a memo for principals to review. They don't just say, yes, you can drone strike weddings, or no, you can't. So when she rejected the first immigration provision, McDonough laid out her reasoning, and buried in that reasoning is evidence of clear bias, but not necessarily in the way you'd think. She wrote in her opinion, the reasons that people risk their lives to come to this country, to escape religious and political persecution, famine, war, unspeakable violence, and lack of opportunity in their home countries cannot be measured in federal dollars. The same is true of the value of having the security of LPR status in this country, LPR lawful permanent residence. So in other words, the policy is so profoundly important that it can't be counted in terms of dollars, and therefore, even though it has a massive budget impact, it can't be thought of as something that can go through reconciliation. But McDonough's experience with immigration is distorting her view of it. She's worked in it, so she understands how important it is. But lots of things are super important. A climate activist would rightly say that creating a sustainable climate for future generations can't be measured in federal dollars. A healthcare activist would say that saving lives by expanding health insurance coverage can't be measured in federal dollars. An environmentalist would say that drilling in Anwar creates immeasurable and irreversible destruction to the habitat, to the planet's beauty, etc., and can't be measured in federal dollars. Yet McDonough has greenlit all those things for reconciliation. Yet in her opinion, she treated immigration reform differently, as if benefits to immigrants are beyond the scope of reconciliation. But somehow rescuing the planet from climate disaster is not? The solution here is obvious. The parliamentarian should recuse herself and allow the president of the Senate to make the call. So, Robbie, imagine you're sitting around waiting for this ruling to come down from on high from this Senate staffer. Like, let me find out what this Senate staffer did before she was working in the Senate. Wonder how this ruling is going to go for us.
It's I didn't know. I didn't know anything, to be frank, about this role part of the conversation
Latino
in the last
Rebels,
few weeks.
Latino Rebels has a great story about this last night. Her role as involved in the deportation machinery has kind of been sort of an open secret, but hasn't been written about much at all.
I have to imagine many Democrats who also didn't really know very much about this person were thinking, wait, there's another way this can all go south? There's another hurdle to climb over, another reason? Like you said in your radar, if Joe Manchin wants to kill this whole thing, he's going to kill this whole thing.
He could just kill the whole thing.
It's probably not going to... I guess that this could provide additional cover, right, if she comes the wrong way on a decision, but probably...
Right, the way it works, so, and people say, well, just ignore the parliamentarian. Yes, ignore the parliamentarian.
But then you have to muster votes to do that.
But then you got to get Joe Manchin to agree to do that. But so it might be the case that she green lights this one, because she's risking her own irrelevance and her own firing. Now, classic Democrats, they would fail first and then fire her quietly later down the road. When it's useless to people, whereas the Republicans fire the parliamentarian on the front end and get in somebody who's going to agree to do what they want to do. But yeah, the whole reasoning that, well, this is such a wonderful thing, you can't measure it in federal dollars, like, well, then nobody says that reconciliation can only be used for trivial things. There's no triviality test to reconciliation.
Has the Senate parliamentarian ever... in recent memory, caused some... I can't remember this being a part of any debate. I just looked the role up, and apparently the last time this was a big deal was in, 1975.
She was a big deal-ish if... Republicans were smart when they did their tax cut, because they proposed it. 2 or 3 weeks later, it was done. So we didn't do this dragged-out, 6-month process. But during that 2-week process, there were some very intense fights. And she actually talks about them in that commencement speech that she had with McConnell. And she blocked, in fact, the most significant one was around the individual mandate. Like, she said that was non-compliant with reconciliation. So that was a major part that they couldn't do. I forget the details of it, but it was something around the individual mandate. And so then they had to leave the individual mandate in, but change the penalty to zero. Remember how contributed to the Supreme Court case, and so that was a thing. But then she also, to get Murkowski's vote for the tax cut, that she wanted drilling in Anwar, and the parliamentarian said, "Sure, drilling in Anwar." According to the CBO, that raises this X amount of money. fine, drilling it. Now, it turned out the CBO was 100% wrong on its on its estimate, which is the other funny thing about allowing technocrats and staffers to like tell right. the Senate what it can and can't do. But McConnell followed all of the opinions of the parliamentarian. If she said something was out, he took it out. If she said something was in, he allowed it in. It was back in 2001 that Republicans got rid of Bob Dove, who was a former parliamentarian, because he was giving them grief about some tax provisions that, that he said couldn't go in. And they're like, all right, well, you're fired. So sometimes, but a lot of Republicans think that McConnell likes having the parliamentarian in there, same way that Democrats do, because it gives him something to hide right. behind.
When it's the other side. When right. it's the other side.
And when he doesn't want to give the wing of his, the right wing of his party, what they're asking for, he'd be like, love to.
Although it seems to me the media is giving the parliamentarian more attention this time.
That's because it's been going for 6 months.
Right.
Yeah. And also, these are huge provisions. Can you do immigration
right.
reform? Can you raise the minimum wage? Like, these are monster, this is, you have people in the House that say, I'm not voting for this if immigration's not in it, which is a huge sleeper question. People are kind of thinking like, they're just joking. They wouldn't hold it up. We'll see.
We're still waiting to find out.
And we'll have more Rising right after this.